Tricuspid valve usually has three leaflets, including anterior, septal, and posterior. Septal leaflet is the longest leaflet, anterior is the largest leaflet, and posterior is the smallest leaflet. Coronary sinus is a very important landmark, especially during echocardiography. If you have coronary sinus in view and one of the tricuspid valve leaflets, is most likely the posterior leaflet. We have got three commissures: posterior septal commissure, anteroposterior commissure, and antero-septal commissure. Of course, tricuspid valve is situated nearly vertically in the chest with about roughly 45 degree angle, and anterior leaflet is situated superiorly. That's why it is sometimes called the superior leaflet, and posterior leaflet sometimes referred to as inferior leaflet. So septal leaflet, this is the most superior part of the septal leaflet, and the most inferior part is next to the posterior leaflet. Now let's see how CT scan can help in identifying the issues with the pacemaker lead. In this loop, which belongs to our patient, we can see many structures, including left ventricle, right ventricle, a massively dilated right atrium, left atrium, and mitral valve. This is the anterior segment, and here we have the posterior segment, and we are scrolling inferiorly. So where we are now, we are in this section, and we are moving downward. So remember, this is anterior, and this is posterior section, and we will be scrolling towards the posterior valve. So if I start the video, now we are slowly moving towards the posterior valve. Here you can see there is no sign of the pacemaker lead, which should ideally be situated in the middle of the tricuspid valve. The other important note in this view is a significantly dilated tricuspid annulus, which here measures about 55 millimeter, which is severely dilated. As we scroll further down towards the posterior sections, so what we're doing, we are moving further downward towards these sections. So here we should have anterior leaflet in view, and here we have septal leaflet in view, and as we are moving downwards, we are going towards the posterior leaflet. Moving further down, still no sign of the pacemaker lead. As we go far inferiorly, pacemaker lead comes into the view. Now we don't have the anterior leaflet in the view anymore, so what we have is mostly the posterior leaflet and septal leaflet. Here we have the lead in view, which is in the most posterior part of the valve and most inferior part as well. So the lead is situated in this area, and it seems that it is embedded into the tissue and it is not in the middle of the valve where it should be.